Hello.
Hello. How are you?
I'm doing well. Yourself?
Yeah, well, I mean, I'm playing Persona, so...
Ah, a JRPG from the 90s, when they peaked.
Hey, Siobhan. Fuck, I've forgotten where I'm supposed to be going. I'm supposed to be going to the Mana Castle, which I thought was to the north.
Greetings.
Hello, Devon.
Yo, Devon. With this slot. Talk to you so you go away. God, I've forgotten everything from last night already. I'm very good at video games. Oh, I remember. I have to go through the subway again.
Fun.
Oh dear.
This demon wants to negotiate with me. What are they? Polisson.
Wise, joyful, and forceful, eh?
I have, like, the actual full list here that's got what to say to every demon to impress it. So I don't actually need to know the details.
Nice.
Yeah, it's cutting out the middleman of learning what the fuck every demon wants by trial and error. So
I realised that what I actually want from this game is for it to just have the negotiation and no combat. Because the negotiation is a combat system in its own right.
Hmm.
And if it was just that, and you didn't have to then fight anything that you failed to negotiate with, it'd be great. But having to fight everything twice is a pain.
Also, you don't get any rewards for negotiating in the game that does exist. So it behooves you to also just fight some shit once in a while.
Yeah.
Hmm.
And which doesn't go well.
I like that in later sort of ones of these, they just kind of make the fighting a bit better.
Yeah.
That would help.
Yeah.
No, this system is just terrible.
SMT4 is really good. But that system depends on you actually taking the time to build a team.
Hmm.
Like, you need to shuffle monsters quite a lot in that one.
Oh, God.
Yeah. So yeah, if you want to play SMT, you need to get used to changing teams.
That's such a pain in the ass, though.
Hmm.
It's time for me to get really excited and shit about Nier again. Because I'm firing that shit back up because there's no rest on there's no stops on the Yoko Taro train.
Which route are you on now?
I'm on C.
Ooh.
Like, I just beat Ending B last night.
I finished that game a few days ago.
Yeah. I have overtaken Becky and then some. So...
Becky had a head start on me.
Yep. But I have Persona to play, and also, like, work is horribly busy at the moment.
Hmm.
It's not fair.
Yeah, I did end up working from home one day.
It's alright for some.
Well, I had to go to the dentist.
Truly a fate worse than death.
I have to get filling put in.
It's probably for the best that you did, like.
Yes. It's for the best, but also getting a filling really hurts.
I am really glad to be playing this on a good emulator, though.
Hmm.
And not on, like, an actual PSP.
Yeah, that too.
See, I played it on the Vita, and I just found the pace to battle really too slow.
Yep. It's an incredibly sluggish game, except between dungeons, where it moves at an incredible rate of knots.
Because, like, the thing about SMT4 that's really good is all the battles are really fast. Like, even boss battles are like 4 turns, maybe.
That's my kind of game.
Oh, I am playing these 2B again. That's interesting.
Yeah.
Also, she has the combat suit on instead of the dress. That kind of owns, and I hope that's a thing I can toggle later.
Sure. I'm not saying anything.
Yeah, I know.
Oops. Too many enemies have natural reflect in this.
Yeah.
That's... yeah.
At least Ellie can afford to lose some HP. Some XP.
It's... The only thing I kind of find annoying about, like, kind of all these games is there's a bit of a trial and error to see what resistances and such they have.
Well, no, I had that enemy scanned. I just forgot.
Ah.
Yeah.
I suppose later ones make the UI kind of more helpful in that regard.
Yeah, you cannot check resistances when you're halfway through an input sequence.
Yeah, no, because I was playing some of Tokyo Mirage Sessions today, and when you, like, have the cursor over an enemy, when you're choosing one, it tells you all of their resistances and weaknesses, which is really useful. Also, if you highlight a move, it'll just show, yeah, this, they're weak to this.
That would be really helpful.
Hmm. I imagine... I'd hope Persona 5 would have something like that. I'd assume it would.
Oh shit, I got a Phoenix Sword.
Nice.
Oh. I need to go see if I can upgrade that.
I never found the guy who does level 4 upgrades.
I did.
Yeah.
He's in the forest castle.
Cool.
Basically, you teleport to the highest, like, fucking, I forget what the fucking word's called. Teleport to the highest transporter in the forest castle, then go back a screen, go to the right a screen.
Okay.
And then there's a block that you can pull, and then it's blocking a door, and in there is Masamune, who is the level 4 guy.
Okay. And... I don't know, but after having a good set of chips in the game, it got really easy.
Yeah.
Yep.
Once I found auto heal and also shockwave, I was just good.
I used the deadly heal.
Mmm.
Which, because I had basically every time, because there's so much, like, small enemies.
But the thing is, in single target boss fights, if you just stand still for 6 seconds, you start getting healed from auto heal.
I forget what it's called, the one where you heal a percentage of damage, because that's...
Oh, offensive healing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Haven't struggled to do enough damage on easy.
I also had pretty much 99 of every healing item.
Yeah, I have 99 smalls just so my auto heal can go off and, or my auto item use can go off and not kill me.
I have 99 smalls, 99 mediums, 99 large as well.
Jeez. Yeah.
The thing is, like, auto heal is good because if I need to chill out during a fight, just dodge enough for 6 seconds and I get at plus 3, 3.6 HP, 3.6% HP per second. So yeah. Like 30 seconds and I'm back to full.
Yeah, it's also just a lot easier to get money the further you get in.
Yeah, it is. I have something like fucking... Yeah, I have 83,000 and I definitely spent like 100,000 on that fucking inventor guy.
I had... Well, I had like probably about like 400,000 by the end of the game.
Yeah.
And just couldn't get rid of the money.
Yeah. I did a lot of upgrade fusing in playthrough A. So I just kind of sunk a lot of that money. And then I didn't have the money to buy shit from Devil and Popola, which I regret.
But
I had to sell up to buy stuff from them.
I want the item pickup one, because like that one
it's
will help
so
me
good.
Farming.
It's so good.
I had some of the... Yeah, I had the item pickup one. I also had the one that... It was one that made a noise every time you hacked someone. And it was just unsettling, so I left it on.
Wise, forceful, and haughty. I can't find this. I think this demon was added for PSP.
Are you using a PS1? Fact.
The FAQs are all only for PS1. There's like one PSP FAQ that we found at all.
That's yeah.
There haven't been many differences so far. Wise.
Yeah, and actually, if you're using the one that you linked, that's its own site, it does have like PSP accounting. Like, it does have like accounting for PSP differences in some bits, but. Hey, Devil and Popola are here. Let's buy these fucking weapons and also like all the good shit. Death Rattle. Enemies emit death cries if defeated by hacking. Okay.
Yeah, that's what I bought.
Why would you buy that? I'm also buying it, but why?
Because, like, I thought, oh, that would be fun. Oh, shit, it's not fun, because they're all screaming. But I'm gonna leave it on.
Auto-collect items, I will sacrifice... Oh, also bullet detonation is good.
Boo. I've never
used
that.
And also, well, basically, like, a lot of my problems with one of the boss fights, one of the, like, the ending A and B boss fight was that he just constantly shot bullets out, and it was really annoying that, like, I couldn't do anything to them, and hopefully this will influence that?
I swear, I don't know whether or not, like, did you get the camera go all funny in the ending B boss fight?
Yeah.
Where you couldn't see the guy.
Oh, that was a...
That might have been a glitch.
The problem for me was in ending A, my lock-on wouldn't work.
Oh.
Which killed me. Obviously.
Yeah,
because,
as you would expect.
See, I had a problem in the ending B-boss fight, which may have been a glitch, but I wasn't quite sure, because I still managed, but the camera was permanently pointing at the floor, and I couldn't see
that. That's not good.
I could lock on, but I couldn't see the guy very well. And it took about 5 minutes.
I need a single crushed nut, and then I can get a level 4 Phoenix Sword.
Oh! Oh my god.
Oh yeah, one of the reasons you want to support the inventor is because his final invention is really good. I won't spoil it for you, but once you finish his quest, he opens a shop, and you can buy meteorite shards from him.
Ooh.
So,
oh.
Yeah.
I'll go back to it. This, at what point does he come in?
He's, at any point once you reach Pascal's village.
Okay, cool. Because this, once you beat Route
3,
C3, you get a chapter select.
Yep. Which is why I've been kind of blasting through the main plot.
But, I wish I knew about that beforehand.
Oh! You might want to do everything before you get the last ending.
Yeah.
I mean,
Nier's history? Yeah.
It is a Nier game.
I mean, you can get away with not having to do everything, but I feel really guilty.
Yeah. Oh, also, I have enough to fucking upgrade the engine blade to the final form.
Cool. I didn't even manage that in FF15 after 100 hours of playing the game.
That's fucking incredible.
I hate this fucking dungeon so much. Why is it terrible?
I feel like that's my reaction to most of that game.
Uh-huh.
I can't actually transport to the forest right now because plot stuff. Oh well. I can still equip the Phoenix Sword. Oh wow, it's bright gold. They did not adequately reflect that in the fucking weapon select screen. It is just glowing in the sunlight. Holy shit.
In Enchanted Arms, there's a town where somebody, like, there's a rich dude asshole character, and his house is literally made of gold, and it's just, that game has bloom issues at the best of times, but the entire front of his house is just gold. It's the most uncomfortable thing I've ever looked at in a video game.
Reminds me of one of the visual bugs I ran into in FF15, where for some reason this one inn, towards the beginning of the game, if you looked inside the inn's window, it would just blind the whole screen with some kind of weird visual bug.
I'm just remembering, there's a bit in Yakuza 2 where you go to a castle, but really the castle splits in half and up comes to, a giant gold castle for some reason. that's the place where you fist fight two tigers.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, I've heard about
Yakuza
that.
Yakuza is so much.
People say, oh, it's from Yakuza 3 onwards, because they don't have the crime writer involved. But no, 2 is cartoony as fuck.
No, there's stuff that I've heard about in 2 specifically that makes me want to get back to play those games, but also I don't have a million hours.
Also, yeah, that's kind of, I spent the first 3 months of this year playing all of them.
Yeah, Jesus Christ, there's been too much stuff out.
Hasn't there just?
I am good at playing video games expediently, so maybe I will get around to them.
It was about 200 hours for me, total,
God,
for the whole series.
I'm getting good at that this year for some reason. I played Nier Automata 48 hours straight.
Fucking hell.
Yeah, I would've,
So this demon has just contacted me to say, what are you planning to do with me? That? Well, this, and the choices are this and that. And
it's...
that is really good.
I think...
Useless from a player perspective, but good.
It's really
very
good.
Very SMT.
I was because I kept track of my playtimes on, Yakuza games, and first you're 15 hours, 18 hours, 19 hours, 3 then go, 4 then goes 28 hours... Then 5 is 68 hours. And it's just, 5 is huge. I don't even do all the stuff in 5.
21-0 is such a fucking tsundere, Jesus. Gonna climb this tower again.
Right. Gonna be off for now. I might be back in a little bit later. But
okay.
See ya.
Take care. Oh. Is that your dog then?
Maybe. I can't hear anything out of my headphones.
I was about to say, it's certainly not my dog. My dog's bark is a bit deeper than that. He was barking at something earlier, but I don't know if... that sounded like it was pretty far away, across the house. Actually, that reminds me, I'm gonna go grab my Switch quick, because... my internet won't load the stream, and I don't want to be staring at my browser.
That's fair. God, every time I think they can't possibly come up with another monster sound effect that weird, they come up with another one. Whoops. Also, it's really hard to turn street corners. I swear, it's not just that they suck. I've opened the castle. Maybe I should... Nanjo, why the fuck didn't you speak up? You... What? Nanjo, that was dumb. I'm gonna go back and make some more personas.
Fuck.
Right,
I failed at a minigame. Bit me in the ass! Oh! This game is teaching me how to be good at shmups.
Yep. I mean, I'm rubbish at twin stick shooters, but I did alright in the Sunken City shmup section.
Fuck! Okay, finally got it.
Welcome back.
Good try with the charm.
Excuse me.
What? What the fuck? That's not how that works.
You alright there?
I hacked a robot, then jumped into a ravine, it died, and 9S teleported down to where it died. That's not how that's supposed to work!
What? Oh man, video games.
You do know you can just click the sticks when you're hijacking something and it blows up, alright? Just making sure so you're not doing that every single time you hijack something.
That's fine. I'm gonna press this elevator button and then wait for it.
So that feature in general seems pretty underutilized. Like, I think I've done it like twice my entire playthrough.
Yeah.
Like apparently you have to sneak up to them to do that, and it's like, okay, why? Like a better idea would be, like, if you do the hacking without taking any damage or something, like, that would be a better way to decide whether or not you can hijack them or not, instead of use stealth in this game that doesn't really do stealth well.
I just remembered I forgot to equip the item pickup. Whoops, let's do that.
God, now I'm remembering the, like, kind of pseudo-stealth stuff in Metal Gear Rising, and that was also bad.
Yeah.
Platinum should just avoid stealth. It's clearly not anything they're good at.
Yeah. Oh, I can just remove the item scan and put in item pickup. That's a good idea. How to collect items. There we go. Everything's good now.
Heck, even Zelda, even Breath of the Wild is better at stealth than that.
Yeah. I mean, not saying much, but also Breath of the Wild stealth is mainly dependent on how many pieces of stealth armor you have equipped.
Yeah, like I did one of the what are the tree people called, the
Koroks?
Yeah, they're trials thing. Which one of them you have to like tail this Korok through this path and.
Oh yeah, that one fucking sucked.
I did it, and then I didn't talk to the guy at the end because I figured I didn't want him to catch me. So I snuck into the shrine and I did the shrine. And then it turned out, oh wait, no, you didn't complete that side quest yet. You had to do it again. And I'm like, why? That seems really counterintuitive.
Yeah, I was just like, well, he stopped. He's celebrating. I should probably talk to him just to be safe. And if I had to do this all over again, I know all this shit because I failed like 4 times, even with the Sheikah armor on. So I was just like...
Oh no, well, I failed a lot of times.
It's really annoying.
It's mostly the end, or well, it's mostly A, the frickin' Korok will just like book it, and he's like impossible to see in the frickin' grass.
Yeah, I along with like hunting for specific lizards for fireproof armor, I had to like, and also just like other armor. I had to put it on the TV so I could fucking see very small details, and it sucked. Because I wanted to play it on the gamepad.
No, I was playing it on the TV and just still, nope, can't see that freaking guy.
It helped that I'm also like less than a foot away from my TV.
Tencent Nyan Nyan. Okay. That's actually a really good set of abilities. But I should teach it an attack spell. So it stats like... Yeah, that's good. Why do I have 3 Mazio stones and only 1 each Magaru and Mabufu?
Different drops, I guess?
Guess so.
I always completely forget about, like battle items in SMT.
Yeah. I can't even create it, though, because my level's too low. Why are you giving me the option? I've still got that fucking option for the level 88 one. Is that any good? Not really.
Just trying to survey the map in Breath of the Wild to see if there's any points of interest that I want to run to before I finally go frickin' talk to Impa and actually progress the main plot. Because I'm probably like 40 hours in and haven't progressed the main plot past the plateau.
That's open world games. It's particularly you playing open world games. I've got a choice for a level 76 persona here as well.
The way I ended up playing Breath of the Wild was I did basically the quote-unquote main plot until it got me the Great Fairy stuff and the Hatano lab. And then I was like, yeah, okay, I should probably, like, actually get on with the trials and shit.
Nope, I did the Noboris Gerudo dungeon, and then I just ran around the map and completed like 70 shrines or whatever, and and then I'm like, okay, I'll do the other dungeons yesterday, and that's what I did the entire day yesterday, was basically doing the dungeons and stuff.
Yeah.
And now I'm just like, well, now I'm kind of out of points of interest to go to. I mean, I'm sure there's probably a lot of stuff hidden, like I...
Yep.
But I don't know, I might just look up, like, somebody's... Like, here's a bunch of neat side stuff to do. Actually, I just found another maze on the map. So I'll go there. Because I really like the shrines that are like, here's a weird, like, overworld thing you have to complete to get to the shrine. I really like those, because those tend to be pretty good.
Yeah.
Like the big mazes, the Eventide Island was really fun to do.
I still haven't done that.
I did that, I was sitting on, like, I think, like, 20, or I think actually almost 30 of the, spirits, because I just didn't run into a goddess statue for the longest time. And I went to Eventide Island, and I'm like, I should have upgraded my hearts before I got here, but I did it anyway.
Wait, so I can only have 16 personas and 12 cards?
Yep.
Well...
Not assigned to your party anyway.
Yeah. And then, like, a total of 15 assigned.
Yeah.
This seems limiting.
Yeah. PlayStation 1. Like, PlayStation 1 SMT.
Yeah, as Barry said, PlayStation 1 doesn't say a lot when you're talking about SMT, because those games are delightfully behind the times.
No, what's really cool is how my fucking left bumper doesn't work, so I can't pop out bomb at any given time. And have to fucking dodge even more to make sure I can press the button hard enough. Oh my god!
I have the opposite problem on my GSOC 4, which is that my right bumper gets stuck down. Which is usually helpful, because it just means you don't have to worry about holding it to fire constantly.
Yeah. I would like to have that problem, but also I have an Xbox One bumper controller, so the bumpers are just garbage in general. I think the only, like, actual improvement to the combat is how fucking 2B uses spears. Because, Jesus, it's like a dragoon in Final Fantasy. And the classic Nier is just like a lancer.
Yeah, the combo when you've got a light sword and a spear, where you dodge an attack with the sword and she goes airborne, and then you can do the spear down attack, is pretty good. Basically the only combo I figured out how to do.
But I'm using Fist and Spear right now, and she's just fucking wrecking shop.
Nice.
Also, one of the, like, Spear on Light, I think Two-Hand Sword on Heavy, is she does, like, this little twirl around the spear She plants it in the ground, does a little twirl around it, and with her foot launches the sword at enemies. It's just like, whoa, okay. That's a little weird, but also awesome.
Like, I think I was telling you, the actual combat improvements that people are going to town about are not, I don't know, it still kind of feels like Nier to me, just with more polish, which is kind of exactly what I wanted.
I like it less, so... That's my controversial opinion, is that the original Nier probably played, like, actually more tolerably to me.
That's fine. Like, I actually really enjoy the original Nier, I guess I kind of appreciate the level of, like, polish and stuff, like, the shmup stuff, like, actually functions a lot better, I think.
Well, I just got one shot by level 60, and this fucking stupid opening to ending or playthrough C where you have to fight all the things as 2B. That's stupid. I really don't like the Goliath's grab attack. It's way too much damage.
It does a lot.
I healed to full and it still killed me outright.
Jeez.
Time to run in and get my fucking corpse back. Because this is Dark Souls, motherfucker. Yep. Do a corpse run and like it.
Yeah. I knew I was gonna hate that mechanic. I wasn't prepared for how much I actually was. I do hate
it. Dying on the crushes in the factory, I thought my corpse had disappeared because I died on the conveyor belt.
Oh.
But it was... The first time I died to the crushes, I was coming down from... I'd done the crushes, and I'd gone across the top of them, okay, and done that room, that treasure room at the top, and I was making my way back, and fell off and died to a crusher. So my corpse was at the door by the treasure room, so I had to get through the whole section with none of my chips. That was a pain.
It's just way too punishing. Like, even by Dark Souls standards, it's even way too punishing. Which is weird.
Yeah.
And like I can kind of appreciate that it's a mechanic that kind of makes sense with, like, in-world stuff, but at the same time, could you make it, like, not the most punishing freaking death mechanic I think I've ever seen in my life?
Yeah.
Just, hey, you died. Congrats. Most your good stats are gone, and you have to go recover the thing without your good stats or with, like, backup stats. And if you die again, you permanently lose those stats. And it's like, that's absurd.
Yep. Wait, I've got card space at the moment. Let's contact some demons.
I'm gonna break your arms, you stupid Goliath! Oh, fuck off, you little stubby!
Oops.
This mob of fucking level 20 Yorha soldiers helping me fight this level 60 monster.
Nice.
Cool.
I could contact these, but also I'm a bit on the low level side, I think. 34. Yeah, I probably am. Fire, ice, wind, earth versus physical. Right, what did you just unlock? That's not going to get us anywhere. This is the problem with healing personas. They are difficult to rank up.
And now the surviving Yorha soldiers are following me, They have shit for health right now. They're probably all gonna die en route. Fuck's sake.
Yep. What actual levels am I? Not my persona levels. 32, 34, 30, 28. God, Mark, why did you do no damage? What the heck are those?
I'm imagining an SMT demon design.
Yep, although this game doesn't actually have the SMT demon designs, does it? It's just got a random set of monster designs.
Does it? I'm trying to remember if it...
Somebody was saying the other day it's a different monster designer.
Oh wait, yeah, because it's just all, like, the battle sprites. It doesn't have, like, the actual portrait art. The Kaneko art.
Yeah. That's the one.
Which, again, I hate that game. I don't like Persona 1. And that just... It's stacking the deck against itself without having Kaneko monster designs. I'm trying to think if he did the character designs for that one, though. Because he has a very distinct art style for his character designs.
I don't think so, because, like, the character designs are barely competent.
Because he was doing the main character design during that time, I think? Or no, I might be thinking of PS2 era stuff.
Oh good, I learned an attack ability. Don't, oh my god, don't do it. I can't get over the fucking monster noises, they're so ridiculous.
Oh, I just realized I'm playing as 2B, I can use the Y button again. So nice!
Oh, is Y hack in,
Yeah, he only gets one weapon. So,
Boy. Hey, treasure room, I bet these explode. actual treasure. Okay.
Oh, mother... They're all censored!
What?
Visual effects. Oh, boy. Oh. Fuck. Oh, I can't jump, I can't shoot, I can't do anything except... gun!
Yeah, yeah, if you're at the part of the game I was at, and I was like, man, I really wish I bought, like, status healing items.
Because, all of a sudden, I need them.
Yeah, that's what it felt like. It's like, oh, I guess I need those, because I don't have any, and I can't do anything.
fun.
So, you know, I mean, I like them conceptually. They're kind of a neat idea. Like, oh, what if status ailments were like cool little glitches in your system? It's like, that's neat. But if you're without them, you can't play the video game. Which I guess isn't that different from like some status ailments from regular RPGs, like being charmed or paralyzed or whatever.
Oh, Jesus! Whoa! Everything just went actually fucked up. Oh, God. Why is everything red? Holy shit.
Yep.
I have 30 more seconds to this.
Yep, I think you're at the exact point of the game I'm thinking. But my screen just turned into a big HD Game Boy for 30 seconds.
This is some virtual boy shit.
I couldn't fight.
That sounds like fun.
No, from what I can see just from skimming Wikipedia quickly, Kaneko is apparently the character designer for Persona 1, which, looking at the portraits, yeah, they do kind of look like his designs, but also they look like bad designs.
Yeah, they're definitely bad designs. Chiffon's saying that the demon I was talking about is a Kaneko design, but doesn't appear very much in... it's only in this and Soul Hackers, so...
I don't know, but like his stuff from like, what's it called? Well, even like Persona 2, his character designs are much better, or like Digital Devil Saga's ones I'm really particularly fond of those character designs.
Oh,
hey, Sam. Welcome back.
What did I miss?
Devin getting very animated about some near stuff.
Oh, if you got to that bit.
Yeah! I'm dying.
Yeah, just status ailments.
Oh boy.
I have not died yet! Oh.
Technically, my game says I never died, because anytime I die, I just reload my save, because screw the frickin'...
Dark Souls bit.
Yeah, the Dark Souls bit.
I never died that way.
I mean, I'm glad that it has as easy of a workaround as I can just reload my save. Instead of losing my chips, potentially. Though it means I have to save constantly, which I would pretty much do anyway.
I probably mashed the dodge button too much.
Once I got abilities like Overclock or whatever, then the game became like trivial.
I still haven't equipped Overclock because why bother?
I kept getting that effect from picking up off of bodies.
Yeah, it seems to be really popular because Bayonetta.
Yeah.
Oh, also, it's just busted.
Yeah, that the online stuff is interesting.
I like the free heals. At least I did until I got the auto heal, and then everything was fine.
Yeah. I don't know. I'm real hit or miss with it. Just the death penalty. The death penalty.
I mean, you're not wrong.
What a weird turn of phrase, but yeah. The penalty for dying is just too severe.
I do agree with you. The death penalty is wrong.
Yeah.
Right.
Starting system abnormal. Okay, I don't need that.
The weird thing about the status ailments in Nier is that, like, I only really ran into them for that one bit, and then they were, like, incredibly rare afterwards.
Yeah.
I definitely haven't seen a status ailment yet.
There's a point in which there are enemies that do inflict them.
So I gather.
Yeah.
And
they
also
are...
you can inflict them on yourself by taking drugs, so...
Yeah, I never did that.
I did.
There's weirdly a lot of stuff I didn't do, despite me like going into it being like, I'm gonna do all the side content, and then eventually when I got like 80% through side quests, I was just like, you know what, no, I've been up for 48 hours, I just want to complete the game.
It's fair. I've done a lot of side content, including some stuff that I really shouldn't have attempted yet. Like, I did the third Father Servo fight at, like, level 16, just with auto-chips.
Yeah,
that took a while.
I did that. I did all those at incredibly low levels, too.
I find that the actual, like, levels, like, it's not, like, you can get away with fighting stuff that's, like, maybe around, like, 15 to 20 levels above you.
Yeah, I found it's weapons and chips that make a lot more damage, a lot more difference. But also, I didn't have any weapons upgraded or any particularly good chips installed at that point. So I was just like dancing for 20 minutes.
Oh, motherfucker! Oh, shit! I can't attack them! Oh, no!
Oh, boy.
Begin the hacking! We're going off book with this shit. Yeah.
Is this just from what's been said? Is this basically Automata's equivalent of the sand of the desert temple from the original?
No, not at all.
Oh, okay. Now I know what she's talking about. No. I mean. I guess kinda that like sometimes you'll get a status of you can't do X, but it's also like random, I think. And it's also something you can avoid and heal.
Fair enough.
It's not like, oh, you absolutely have to do this thing this way.
Man, these things don't have a tell anymore. I knew this was gonna happen. They were trying to get you ready with side quests where this happens. Oh dear.
Helen Force, Null Magic, Weak Physical. Okay. Wait, what levels are they? 32 and 33. I might be able to recruit these. Wise and joyful anatomy. No. Hooray! I recruited a thing. And I finally reached the third floor.
Yay!
Progress. There's a room over here. Dead end. Okay, this demon's talking to me. It's a djinn. There we are. Okay, persuader stopped working. Jin.
Oh wow, they just do not stop coming, huh? Time to bail and get to the mission point. Oh boy.
What? Oh. So I should not use fire on this. Okay.
I heard a scream.
Did you?
Yeah.
I think it was something in my house.
I hear laughing from this video game.
I can imagine that being quite disturbing. Quite a disturbing thing to hear in a near game.
This thing's only level 50, it has a bunch of adds, but I can deal with those, and by that I mean I dodge the fuck out of them.
There's a very large room the other side of this wall. Apparently missing one. Oh, maybe this is the section in darkness. Which would suggest that I am not going the right way. I don't know what's got into my throat this evening. Cats don't like to be whipped. Okay.
Motherfuck, these things combo real hard.
Dizzies. Okay, I'm definitely not recruiting that. No, that was okay. Ah, stairs down again. Live. Almost getting to the level where I can start recruiting demons.
I will say one thing with the optional mazes in Breath of the Wild is they're considerably less fun when you realize that most of their gimmicks are you have to climb to the top to and jump into a hole.
Yeah.
Like, the first one I did was in, like, a mountainous region, and I was having a lot of fun with it, and then I realized, wait a minute, this is unsolvable. And I climbed to the top and was like, oh, that was the freaking gimmick the whole time. And, like, I did my second one, and immediately I'm just like, I'm just gonna start from the top and jumping in every hole, and I found it, like, immediately.
I still barely made any progress in that game.
I did all my, at least, plot progress yesterday, like, all of it.
Maybe I should just play that in a bit more of a focused manner for a bit.
I don't know, I seem to have more fun with it not focused, though the main dungeons are all pretty solid, I think.
Cool, I wandered into Hyrule Castle for a bit, and that was a bad idea.
I have yet to do that, actually.
I have 5 hearts, so...
Like, I completed, like, most of the game's optional content around, like, 5 hearts, because I stockpiled on the upgrade item and just never got around to finding a statue to cash them in.
Yeah. No, I've just been, like, trying to buy them as soon as possible, because otherwise I will just keep dying.
Stop punching me! Holy shit! There's like 8 enemies and they all want me real bad. Luckily for me, I have dodge and a fucking phoenix sword, so...
That will help.
And they are unarmed, so they're only doing unarmed Yorho damage. Stop punching me, goddammit! Stupid idiot. Let's fucking bail.
Oh my god, these fuckers can heal for like 300 at a time. Apparently I can still take them out though. And another room. Wow, that's a lot of treasure chests. What? Every treasure chest in this room is going to be trapped and lowered my HP to 1, isn't it?
That definitely sounds like a good possibility.
I've done 5, there are 3... Oh, that one exploded. But it did have something in.
You might want to heal.
Yeah, I did. What I got was...
I do wish the guardians weren't as much of a pain in Breath of the Wild as they are.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know, I fought a couple of them and they're just really not fun to fight, they're really not fun to avoid, they're just annoying.
Yeah.
Which is a shame because they were like a major focus of like trailers and stuff and they look really cool, but at the same time it's like, yeah, I never want to encounter those and not in like any sort of like... Like, oh, what an intimidating enemy to run into. No, it's just, what an annoyance. Get away from me.
It's a shame when that happens.
Yeah, I found a room that was like, oh, here's an old-ass temple, and here are 8 fucking guardians in this one fucking room.
Wow.
And they're immobilized, so, like, they're not moving around and being a pain, but also... I don't want to fucking play that. I don't want to play with that.
Yeah.
And there are supposedly, like, guardian killing arrows that exist. But I've tried them and they don't do enough damage to be worth it.
Apparently, yeah, like, I've only had one of them the whole game. And I guess you need to, like, hit them on the, like, a direct hit to the eye and... I'd imagine you probably have to have a certain power bow to do it in one shot, too.
Just that shield.
Yeah, if you beat the little guardians in the temples, they drop shields that you can parry the lasers with, but fuck me, that's hard.
So that room full of trapped chests was a massive detour to get to for 2 items.
Oh.
One of which I think was a unique fusion item, but also fuck this game.
Devin, was the area you were just talking about one of the mazes?
I completely spaced on what I was talking about. No, it wasn't.
Okay.
It was just.
I'm at the northernmost maze, and yeah, it's just crawling with guardians.
Oh yeah, fucking that place. I just, that place sucks.
I'd imagine that the solution is I gotta crawl to the top and find a hole.
No.
Oh wow, for once they actually didn't do that again.
It's just go to the northwestmost corner and there'll be a path to get you to the shrine.
Alright.
The rest of the maze is chuff. It's chaff. It's nothing.
Yeah.
Well, that's everything exploding during the credits. This is a video game.
Sounds about right. So is that ending C then?
Maybe? I don't think so.
No.
No. Oh, if he's where I believe he is, no.
I feel like you've just started Route C.
Yeah.
You will know when you're at the end. This time. I'll just say that much. It's not like ending A where... I accidentally ran into the ending plot triggers and went, oh, okay, I guess that was ending A.
Yeah, that just kind of happens.
Like, I didn't know ahead of time that, like, the game was kind of structured similarly to Nier 1 with the two halves thing.
It's kind of not, in a way. Like, I think that this one is more like, because there's only, like, you repeat the start more than you repeat the second half.
I mean, yeah, that's obviously because chapter select, which, you know, is Which is great because I didn't find repeating for like ending C and the original Nier good use of my time. Mm-hmm. I mean, I still did it, but I just felt like it's like, you know, you could have just like, okay, you did ending B, here's a, like, well, what Onimana does, a chapter select would have been nice.
Yeah.
Or just like, oh, you completed it, like, I don't know, just some kind of shortcut to get you to the end so you can get to the final choice. Hmm. Well, I guess what's intended is that, like, your playthrough C is supposed to be you getting all weapons or whatever, but no, I did that my, like, first playthrough.
Yeah, I did that on Cycle B. I mean, the thing with C and D in the original Nier is that, like, they take an hour each.
Yeah, I mean, the,
if that.
I was having this argument with somebody on Twitter, and they are trivial to do. It's just, that's an hour that I kind of wish I didn't have to do. Because it doesn't... Yeah. It's because just not a good... Like you don't gain anything. I've seen people complain, like, oh, I don't want to redo the game for B when I'm overpowered. That's just boring. But it's like, no, that's part of the point.
It's also just, in Nier 1, repeating for C and D, it's kind of like, a lot of the stuff that you do repeat, you don't get any extra context to.
Yeah, exactly, that's my point.
I mean, like, I feel like it works for pacing, though. There's got to be something to put a little bit of space between ending B and ending D.
I mean, that's the thing. Yeah, going, playing Automata and doing C, D, and E within, like, an hour is a bit much.
Oh, yeah. Like that was really jarring to me because I was like, okay, I did C. I guess I'll go to bed and do the rest later. And then it's like chapter select. It's like, oh, I could just finish this right now. I'd agree that does take away from it a little bit.
And like, I guess, like, if you do, I'm doing it twice is a bit much, but also, if you, most people are going to know that D is going to be the, like, the important ending to get. So lots of people are just going to go, oh, I'll skip ending C then. And for the people who skip ending C, I think it really does need something to make sure that ending D takes a bit of time.
Yeah.
I mean, the game doesn't really need ending C at all, but...
It's just there, so if you want to clear up anything else, you can have your final situation.
It's if you go through it a third time and not realize, oh, I've got stuff I still need to do.
Yeah.
Did side quest progress carry over in the original?
Yes.
The only thing was there was 51% of the side quests were in the first half of the game, which you could not repeat. But there were also no, like, there was no trophy or anything for getting 100%.
I don't even know if there's one for Automata. I know there was one for 80.
There's 80%, yeah, but...
Which I got. I didn't know if one of the hidden ones was, like, 100 or something. But that would be dumb.
Is there a vendor that just sells the achievements?
Oh my god, this fucking detour for this fucking treasure room that had nothing in it! Ah! I'm still on it! I'm still backtracking!
Maze dungeons, huh?
You're not wrong. I mean, dungeon crawler dungeons, really. It's like, this is not a mage dungeon in the sense that some Final Fantasy dungeons are maze dungeons.
Yeah, I feel... dungeon crawler stuff lately has been a lot easier to manage. Mostly because you can see a bigger picture map, usually.
Maybe. And but I don't play a lot of dungeon crawler type games, but this is... I mean, it's not completely old school SMT, but it's pretty much old school SMT.
It kind of is, yeah. I was just thinking, like, that...
I don't know, some SMTs do the maze dungeon thing a lot better, like, I played the first Megami Tensei, like, 6 months ago, and I did that without a guide, and I actually had a lot of fun with that. And the original Megami Tensei is just one big dungeon, separated into chunks.
Waltz of Sadness. Of course there's a status in this game called Guilt.
Yeah, I told you about it.
Wait, what does it do?
I don't fucking remember. I definitely told you about Guilt being a status, though.
Apparently, it probably
prevents you from acting or something.
It looks like it makes your physical attacks have a chance to not go off or something.
Please let me move properly, video game.
Huh, I just found a armor piece in Breath of the Wild that just straight up has Guardian Resist.
Yep.
That'd be helpful.
And oh no, the Guardians came to life.
Yep.
No, oh no, there's too many. Getting out of here. at least that was a fun little detour of the labyrinth. Just, hey, here's your Guardian Resist items, but now there's like six of them surrounding you. So good luck, and I'm like, nope. Running away. Because fighting Guardians is not fun.
Yeah. You can, like, there's a, you get, stop, fucking video game, I'm not allowed to walk a proper speed, and I'm getting punched by robots, because this is a segment where the game gets dumb on you. Let me move.
Okay. That's dead end. This way past the staircase. Is this going to be another long path with no fucking thing at the end?
I was gonna say that there are ways to make Guardian Resist armor, but they are a pain to make. They require a lot of materials.
I'd imagine you make them in the labs.
Yep, the second lab. Stop fucking shooting me.
The only lab I found was the Akala lab.
That's the one.
And I didn't know that apparently you need to progress the plot in order to unlock the little side quest to unlock that lab.
Yep.
That's so
the
reason
you do the fucking main quest, because also you can get upgrades to bombs and sensor and fucking... What else? Stasis.
Yeah.
Great.
No, I did the whole torch thing, though, and I'm glad that the torch thing stays, so that way when I do get around to it, I already have the torch bit finished. But I did that bit, and I was like, okay, now is it gonna unlock? Then, you know, and I was just standing there with the blue flame, like, oh, what am I supposed to do? And then I looked it up, and it's like, oh, you have to progress the main plot. And it's like, oh. That explains why I can't do it.
Let's cross this fucking bridge. I hope I can make it across without getting mauled by robots.
Oh dear.
Now I know exactly where you are.
I know exactly where they are.
Yeah, that's why I was getting mad earlier, because I was trying to climb the fucking the pit. The robots kept smacking me.
So, that bit that I'm almost certain you're at, I had to do keep redoing, because I was doing all endings, like, with a spoiler-free guide. And I didn't know about the chapter select, so I had to reload that bit multiple times because there's a lot of endings surrounding that area.
36, so there is no way in hell I'm gonna be able to recruit them. That's annoying.
I was so mad when I figured out there was chapter select because, I was really mad when I didn't even know there was fast travel and I did all the frickin' side quests at the beginning of the game before fast travel was available.
Yeah, I saw that and that said, I'm gonna wait until there's fast travel.
Yeah, same.
Thank you.
Especially the frickin' I forget what his name is, but the philosopher robot freaking side quest.
Jean-Paul.
Oh, sorry. Say that loud as a big beep.
Yeah,
like that side quest I did without fast traveling.
I don't think I fast traveled doing it, but I do just like running around.
I mean, I didn't hate it as much as I'm going on about now, but it is kind of irritating. It's like, oh, I just realized I could have made that thing, like, 30 minutes shorter.
I found out about the chapter select, and I was just like, well, I'll just hold off on doing side quests and shit, so.
I don't know, some spoilers are good spoilers, like...
Yeah.
I don't know if I want to spoil it on stream here, but the Master Sword gimmick was a good thing to know beforehand.
Yeah.
Well, there's like certain things which you could call spoilers, and some things is just less quality of life thing.
I mean, yeah, but there's of course some people are like, no, it would have been more interesting to be a surprise, and I don't know. I don't really see that for a lot of things, especially something like there's fast travel in this game, there's character select, or there's chapter select in this game.
Yeah.
I mean, not everything needs to be a surprise.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, but there are some people who are really picky.
I mean,
picky
those people
that.
Are probably not among the 5 people currently listening to the stream, 3 of whom are currently in this conversation.
I mean, I wouldn't be on the stream viewer list.
Yeah.
Because I can't load the stream, so I just closed it. Devin, was there any side content in Breath of the Wild that really stuck out to you that I might have not done yet?
You can buy a house.
Okay, where's that?
Hateno Village.
What village?
Hateno Village.
Okay, Hateno. That's
you'll get there when you do the main quest.
No, I already have Hateno Village. I found it.
But yeah, that's also where the tech lab is. The other tech lab, if you climb the big hill.
Oh, okay, that explains why I didn't find it, because...
You thought it was in the village.
Well, I remember some... I don't know, I was watching somebody stream, and I remember there was a lab there, but I didn't look too hard through Hateno, because I was like, oh, this village doesn't have much in it, I guess.
Yeah. So, the way you get to the house you can buy, which costs 10 bundles of wood and, I think, 3,000 rupees?
Ooh. I think I have that.
Yeah, is you, when you come out of the shrine, or you teleport to the shrine, you go forward towards the houses, and then you go to the left, there's a bridge you can cross, and over there is a guy working on stuff. And once you buy the house, you can also start a quest where you help build a frontier town in over by Akala. So,
what's a good way of getting rupees?
I don't know. selling ores.
Yeah, I just sell crap that I'm not currently using.
Oh god, why?
What the fuck is coming out of the ground? Oh boy.
Oh boy.
Yep, my butt.
Wow. Can you imagine some people only play through A and go, yeah, that's enough for me.
That not got even... me a Maximilian tweets.
It's not even half the game.
It's like a third or a quarter. Jesus.
I think from my playtime, it's half.
From mine, it certainly is, because I did a lot.
I mean, you've done all the other endings as well, basically.
Yeah, though the endings, the optional endings are very backloaded too. I feel like a good chunk of them are right at the beginning of ending C. Well, I also didn't do all the optional endings. There's one I didn't do.
I think it's, I think getting to ending C/D takes about as long as it takes to do A. Because you're basically at the second half of the game at that point.
How are we doing on this floor? Yeah, so that dummy path that I was on goes all the way round the outside of the fourth floor of this dungeon. And has a bit on the fifth floor and a bit on the third floor. Now, this is the bit I needed the guide for. One step... I can't go south.
Oh, I have to select a character to play.
Yep. Doesn't matter which one.
Yeah.
Yeah, so that's what effectively replaces like a playthrough D other than chapter select is you get to switch in between the perspectives this time.
Yeah.
Which is nice, but it also feels kind of weird.
Well, it's like you could just because like if you just do all of one character you can just then do all the rest of the characters. Like you just can go between the two.
Yeah, I traded on and off.
I went without one of the characters for a while because I felt that might have been the more interesting way to do it.
I think I did the same.
Because the one I went out without was that I imagined like they become more seething with rage.
Yeah.
Why does this game have a bad tactical combat system? I'm so sick of it. Just, you can't, this character can't do anything, because they can't reach.
It is the worst. Like, I don't even like tactical combat systems in their own genre. But, like, that on top of the frickin'... On top of SMT combat, which I really like. So, seeing a thing that's like, oh, it's the thing you like, but mixed with a thing you despise.
I've only really liked the press turn system.
I like that a lot more than most of the other ones. But, yeah.
I think the press turn system I kind of find more interesting than, like, the one more sort of thing that's in Persona.
Shit, I have a taunt button now.
Woo-hoo! I don't really care about
that's really fun.
Persona 3 and 4, like, stun and all-out attack stuff.
See, I really like that because it means that you can make combat not a very big part of the game.
Yeah.
But I'm a scrub like that.
Well, it's the thing, it's just like Persona doesn't make fights hard, it makes them long. Like, isn't doing any of that with like the main fights, but the boss fights like are just long, not hard. I mean, the first couple felt a bit of a challenge, but then after that, they just stop. With that, and then they just go, here's a guy with just a whole bunch of HP.
Yeah. I really like slugfight bosses, though. Where it's just, like, you just nibble them to death.
I think I like that, but I also... But it didn't feel as though I was in any trouble.
That's so certainly fair.
Kind of a bit... Just felt a bit lengthy.
There's another Persona game I was playing recently, Soul Hackers, that has... It's not quite a tactical system, but it does its encounters in, like, rows, and like, some moves can only attack a certain row or whatever. So it's kind of like a lighter version of what Persona has, which is a lot more tolerable, but I also don't like it, which is... kind of why I dropped playing Soul Hackers.
I have Soul Hackers. Because it's probably just super cheap in some...
Knowing you.
I think I bought it when it was on sale. It's only available in English on 3DS.
Yes.
Because it was a Saturn game, I think.
Yeah, it was a Saturn game. It might have been on the PS1 as well.
Maybe. I don't think in English, though.
No, not in English.
I think I have a really good chip for taunting.
And, you know, even on the 3DS, sometimes you can see it's very much a Saturn game when it does, like, the 3D transitions. And it's like, woo, this 2D scene is now 3D and you're moving through it.
Yeah.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, it had a PS1.
It had a hell yeah.
Japan.
Taunter's player and enemy attack power to 200%. That's a good thing to have. I don't know why I had it before this character, though.
Yeah, it's the chips are weird like that.
Yeah.
They just kind of just give you all the chips. Because the Devil Summoner was all mainly Saturn stuff. I was just thinking, like, what if I had means to play Saturn games, what would I actually play?
I would play Shining Force 3.
Hopefully a mod without the English voices.
I mean, there's literally no way to play the second and third parts of that game without modding, like, getting the fan translation, so, like...
Mm. But I think... You'd want to mod the first the English voices out the first one, because they are really bad.
I don't care.
I suppose it might be... they're kind of bad in a funny way, though. If you look at it a certain way.
That was a perfectly timed level up for Maki, because she just ran out of MP.
Okay. Time to see if I can teleport to the forest.
Maybe...
Yes, I can. Let's get to the Royal Chamber and then upgrade some fucking weapons. Hopefully.
Maybe I'll try Panzer Dragoon Saga, because everyone says that's amazing, because it's a hard game to get. That's how I feel. It probably is.
Quite possibly.
Because that seems to be the case.
It is how it usually goes.
I mean, Suikoden 2 and The Last Story are supposed to be amazing.
Not that you're salt or anything.
I got so fucking pissed at the last story.
Whoa, shit. Why has Mark taken so much damage? Presumably I am not paying enough attention. That's the other problem with having two combat systems. You've got... Basically... You have to do... Like, combat to get the XP to be able to do demon recruiting. Mm-hmm. So the interesting system is gated behind the shit one. Also, I love that, like, a dark area has an actual texture to show darkness beyond here, and that it's not a very dark texture.
I just realized that machine cores are selling for more with each ending I get.
Oh, really?
Huh.
I think.
Well, you get more in further playthroughs.
Yeah, but also, like, they in my first go, they sold for like 10k, and then 9S they sold for 15k. Now I'm in this, and it's 22.5k.
That's probably had some money by pretty cool. I'm glad I haven't sold my machine cores yet.
I mean, I sold them when I needed them, and then I got a shit ton more in playthrough B, so it's not like I ever wanted to hold on to them, really.
Oh, you know when you go to the Sunken City for the first time?
Yeah.
And there's that, like, pair of brass enemies that just have millions and millions of HP that you get a machine core from.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Those are golden.
They look like brass to me. Anyway, is there any trick to those, or do they just have millions of HP?
They just have millions of HP.
I only killed, like, one group of them, and I was like, nope, I never need to do this.
I only even encountered them in playthrough B, and I encountered all of them in playthrough B.
I think I'd seen someone that recommends you be like mid-level 60s.
Wow.
That sounds about when I killed them.
I did it like 40, and I also like killed the one in the city, then in the desert, then. Other way, like, I did all of them all in one playthrough of 9S.
I started taking on the ones in desert, and then I just went, oh, I can't off it. And then just ran off.
They drop a lot of money and also machine cores, so I was just like, hey, that works for me. Time to go fight shit in the desert, yay.
Well, I'm gonna be off, guys. You have
good night.
A lovely evening. See ya.
Oh, also one of the items you get for helping out the inventor is a better. Fucking sachet, whatever the fuck, however you're supposed to say that. That's a big sand enemy. That makes enemies, or not enemies, animals wait for you.
Shitting me, video game. Guess who's found another pointless diversion? Oh, why?
Oh man, all of her, all this character's dodging is in the colors of the engine blade because I have it equipped. Oh my god, it shows the stupid fucking Final Fantasy 15 font damage numbers.
Yep.
I forgot about that.
And that's why I unequipped it. I don't like how it looks.
This is...
I don't mind the warp strike dodging because I think that actually looks cooler than the automatas. But I don't like the Final Fantasy font thing. Also, I never found the, what's the Dragon Quest stick called?
The Cypress stick?
That also changes the font.
Oh, does it? I have that. It's like a weird platforming challenge. You have to jump across pillars before you reach the forest castle, and it's in a chest up there. I got it.
Oh, I might go get that. That sounds like fun.
I was watching somebody's, it's one of those soundtrack videos that they also play game footage with, and they were using that. It's like, oh, I forgot that was a bonus item in this game.
Yeah, I kind of want to upgrade it, and oh Jesus, that's a big, weird centipede monster.
The one in the desert, or just the regular ones you see? Oh, okay. Now I know where you are.
Okay, so there might be access to another staircase on this floor. I hope.
I'm glad this town's perfectly fine with me chopping down all their trees.
Berserker mode! Hell yes! Gonna go Ripper on this thing.
I wish I liked that.
Limited released!
I wish I liked that mechanic as much as I was hoping I would. Because I don't like the self-destruct mechanic, like, it's just kind of weird, and...
And also, it includes the fact that you have to get your shit back.
Yeah. Just... But, like, the Berserker mechanic, it's... It's cool, It's a very platinum mechanic to do. But at the same time, I wasn't... I don't know, it just doesn't work out as well I was hoping, I guess. Like, I think I literally only used it on the boss. It was introduced, and I was like, oh... I don't know, it also clicking both sticks, like I know that's kind of a standard thing, but I've never really liked
having to hold it for 2 seconds is what fucks it up for me, because it's
okay yeah, that maybe that was it, because like I don't know, that's also kind of a standard thing, is like click both sticks to activate the powered up mode, and I've never really liked that because I always forget those buttons exist, let alone pressing them together.
I just hate using them. Like, I will fidget and click them forever, but, like, I hate actually having to hold them in for anything.
They're not made to be held in very well.
No, yeah. they're definitely not made to be held in. I think most of the Platinum Clover games, they're just click, though I might be remembering wrong. Automata...
For the self-destruct, it makes sense, because it's like, oh, yeah, don't blow yourself up, but Berserker mode, why do I have to hold it in?
I guess it's because they don't want you accidentally activating it when... And it does have a steep, like, cost to it, if I remember correctly.
It's basically Therianization.
Yeah, which is why I thought I'd like it. But I just never used it, I guess. I don't know. I'm going to go back to that game one of these days to try to wrap up stuff that I missed. mods, and maybe I'll play around with it more. Also, I think I just found a Satan statue in Breath of the Wild.
Yep, that is definitely a thing.
Satan statue.
Yeah, you can deal with a devil.
Fair enough.
To actually use it, I think you have to... You might have to talk to a little kid in the village who's just like, hey, you want to see something cool? And he's just like, yeah, I found the devil in a statue.
I mean, I just found it and, like, I'm talking to it, so...
There is a quest for it, too, though.
Alright.
I've somehow ended up with a very explosion-heavy party, and it's not optimal.
That's a funny joke you just told. Explosions are always the best option.
But, like, so much is resistant to them in this.
Which is bullshit.
Yep.
Huh. I did not... I mean, I don't know why I didn't expect it to do something like this, but I just lost a heart container.
Yeah.
God damn.
There's a reason for it. If you talk to him again.
Now I feel like I'm playing Binding of Isaac again. Which... I don't know why I put half as much time as I did into that game.
Nope. All of this is more pointless fucking diversion.
Just find the critical path.
I'm trying! right. Yeah,
I'm trying to think if there's any guide.
I'm gonna go to the guide now as soon as I get back to a point that I know I can pick up the guide from.
I'm trying to I'm pretty sure I used a guide for that game because I got to the final dungeon. I was like, you know what? No, I just want to end the game. And then I did. And then I was like, well, this was certainly not a game worth playing. Well, the very end of it is interesting in some specific ways that I think I'll just leave as a surprise. But, I mean, I think anytime Devin brought up the schedule for the past couple months, I'd be like, you're gonna have a rough time.
I mean, we played Sonic. Fucking Suikoden 2, it's just like,
I mean,
play some of these things.
I mean, I'd imagine you played worse, but
yep.
At the same time, like Persona is... Persona 1 is... It's bad, but at the very least, it's like a really off version of a decent series, depending on what your tastes are.
I vastly prefer this to any other experience I've had with Persona. Except for the combat. I would rather have Persona 3's combat.
Yeah, I was about to say, it's like I definitely... I don't know, it's why I really want to get back to 2, but... I always forget about 2 because it's from the little bit I played, it definitely doesn't have the stupid tactics light thing, and it's also not a freaking 120-hour visual novel like the later ones. It's much more the structure of 1 with less of the bullshit.
It's the structure that's really working for me with this. Like, just...
Yeah, like...
Dungeon,
like the one thing I'd take
burst of plot,
one
dungeon,
is...
burst of plot really quickly. But,
yeah. Yeah, like if there's anything from Persona 1 and I guess 2 is I wish the series stayed like this and didn't turn into these massive, massive visual novels of characters I really don't care about.
I love how... When the demons ask for, like, a sample of your life, the prompt for yes is always really cheerful. Like, okay, sure.
Yeah, the fucking funny thing is, like, people who would actually play, like, Persona 3 and 4 and love them wouldn't actually just play a visual novel.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, I fucking remember watching some fucking Polygon thing, because Polygon comedy series are the only reason they exist. So I was watching one of those, be like, hey, here's my tribute to the shitty games journalism god. Here's my click. And fucking Nick Robinson said something like, yeah, I really like Persona, but I really wish it was just a visual novel. And I'm just like, fucking play a visual novel, you shit.
Yeah. And you know what? I think I'd agree. I wish that Persona would be a visual novel series and it would go away from SMT so I can have SMT games with, not that I think that the 4 games are bad, but, you know, sometimes I was like, you know, I wish that there was regular SMT games that got that level of polish and visual flair.
And also attention.
Yeah.
Like in general.
You know, like, everybody's pining for, like, another Nocturne, which I'm hoping that's what the Switch game ends up being is, you know, like, oh, we're gonna finally dump some budget and, like, make, like, a... But, like, there is definitely something really compelling about the way that Nocturne looks that you wouldn't get from, like, a... Like a... From, like, a 3DS game where the monsters are all portraits.
Yeah.
Well, that part's not so bad, because the portraits are good, except for the non-Kaneko designs, which are... I forget the dude's name, but it's some...
The one...
It's some frickin', I think, like, Kamen Rider designer, and just know that his demon designs are awful, and I can't wait to see what he designs for the frickin', Final Fantasy XIV thing.
Yeah.
I forget. Is he on the...
He's on the Omega Return weapon? No, he's on the Return to Ivalice. 24-man raid.
Yeah. So, expect very Kamen Rider looking people and some really horrible looking monstrosities, probably. Though if he sticks to the more Kamen Rider looking people, that would be fine. Because, like, particularly his Odin design in SMT4 is really good because it looks like a Kamen Rider character. And that's pretty much what they're good at.
You can count on us maybe doing a Strange Journey or Nocturne episode like year 4 or something. Because, like, we got a lot of shit to get through.
Also, those are pretty long games, right?
Yeah, especially if you want to do True Demon ending for Nocturne.
I think from what I've heard, I'd probably be more interested in Strange Journey, personally, but I don't know much about either game, to be honest.
Nocturne's more of, like, here's the mainline a mainline SMT with, like, budgets, and it's, like, full 3D and stuff.
And has Dante.
Yeah, well, Dante, of course. And I think what's more compelling about that game, though, is its world design is really good, because it's this weird, like, I think they literally just call it, like, the Vortex World, which is, like, the world was destroyed, and it's, like, in this weird state of, like, rebuilding itself, and just everything looks really, really cool, because it's, like, this weird, like, it's not really, like, post-apocalyptic, it's don't know. It's really hard to describe. And Strange Journey is the more
sci-fi.
Yeah, it's more sci-fi and particularly leaned more towards like a Western taste of sci-fi, I think.
I played a bit of it and it was interesting, but I then stopped playing it and never went back to it, so.
Oh boy. No, I need to get back to Strange Journey and I need to replay Nocturne sometime because I played it forever ago. And now I've just anytime somebody's like some streamer's doing I'm doing my Nocturne playthrough, I frequent those because those are just really fun to watch.
Okay, I get it now. So the cameo weapons only do their special stuff if they're at a high enough level.
Oh.
Hey, Odai. Electric nuclear gravity blast.
Because I only have a cypress stick at level 1 and it's not doing anything special.
Okay.
And my engine blade did do the blue sparkly thing before it was level 4, but once it hit level 4, then it started doing the numbers.
Okay, that explains it then. Alright, I figured out what the Satan statue does, and no. I think I'm good.
It's fine. It lets you get the Master Sword earlier if you spent anything on stamina vessels.
Oh, yeah, I guess that would be pretty useful.
God, there's a whole area of this floor I haven't been to.
Like, if I had known that I could trade my stamina vessel temporarily for the Master Sword, I would have been like, hell yeah. But I didn't find that out until after, because I didn't spend any fucking time in Hayateno Village.
I'm kind of tempted to remove a lot of my heart containers for more stamina, but also I think I'm just fine. Because I'm pretty much done with the game almost.
I mean, the thing is, it's really nice to have at least 2 wheels of stealth. Or stealth? Stamina. I meant stamina. I'm bad at talking and also playing an action game. But, yeah, it's really good to have 2 circles, because that pretty much covers you climbing any fucking thing in the game, and also gliding. You can basically glide any fucking distance you want.
Yeah, I have the 2 circles, and I mean, I've seen other people with their screenshots where they have like this monstrosity of circles, and it's like, and I'm just trying to think, like, when on earth would you even use that much?
Yeah, like if you want to do the power, if you want to do power attacks with a 2-handed weapon, sword weapon, you can just swing for even longer. But it looks pretty goofy, and you don't need to do that too often.
Yeah. I also never do the power attacks because I'm afraid I'm always gonna accidentally use
Urbosa's Fury.
Which is
it only triggers after the second like little tick of the power attack.
Yeah. I don't know. I don't like how the spells are. Well, I don't mind the Rito one, the flying.
The Gale? Yeah.
Revolver. Like, I don't mind how that one works. And in the Mipha's Grace one works fine. It's
basically just a better fairy, and I'm fine with that, yeah. But like Durg's Protection, having it just be an extra thing that happens while you guard makes it run out really quick.
I suppose, though, I'm the type of person who is like, no, I wanna save this for the boss fight or something, and I just use it
because it's an easy guardian kill, because it auto parries their lasers.
Oh, I never realized that.
And you get three casts of it, and that's usually enough to, like, actually kill one. If you don't want to fucking bother.
Hino in...
I don't know, but Urbosa's Fury is definitely the... It's a cool spell, but at the same time, it's like...
Why put it there?
Yeah, it's like, why put it on my charge attack? I don't want to use it right now. But I don't know, that's also my obsessive resource management type thing that's really unnecessary.
Yeah, it's... I mean, I really don't like using... I usually say that for, like, enemies that I don't want to fucking bother fighting. Like, a Hinox or a Lynel or one of those big fuckers in general.
Also, fighting enemies in general in this game... is, since there's no, like, experience or anything rewarding you for combat other than, like, monster parts, you kind of you get to a point where it's like, okay, you know what, I'm just gonna avoid all combat.
Yeah, that's one of the big issues I have with it.
Because, you know, like, I have these cool weapons and I don't want to break them on a freaking couple chumps.
Yeah.
Right. Let's try this again with a guide.
Emil, please stop running around. I want to buy things from you.
Shoot him.
Well, that's what you need to do. But that reminds me, one of my biggest problems with Nier Automata is NPCs who won't talk to you unless you're out of combat, and the game being really finicky on what it counts as being in combat.
Yeah, okay. Like, Neil apparently has just a bunch of fucking good equipment right now.
Is this the first time you've ran into a door?
No, I bought both of the weapons he had, and a dress module, and a bunch of shit.
Yes, the dress module, aka the best thing to equip on 9S.
And I have 133,000 G, and I don't know what to spend it on. Might as well. I'm gonna buy a bunch of EXP game up plus threes. Oh, Shockwave plus threes. I'm also gonna buy two of those. I'm gonna fuse these later and just make everything really good again. Even better. Taunt up, 280%! I'm gonna buy two of these and fuse them together! Yeah, fuck it, let's buy four of them!
Mm-hmm.
Okay, we're doing this, and we're looking for a staircase. Specifically that staircase. One advantage of the 2 hours I've been fucking around in this castle is that I've made about 500,000 yen.
Guess what? If you want to prepare for the Snow Queen route to do the hardest tower first and thus be able to fuse ultimate personas for all of your party members, you gotta do that off of starting enemies.
Fun. I'll check these are the ones that we invite. Okay, second floor. Wait, what? Now the fucking guide is sending me to rooms I've already gone to get treasures I've already got. I'm not having a good time here. So.
Oh, the giant drill snakes are annoying.
The floaty ones with the...
Yeah.
That first appear in the crater.
Yep.
Yes, they are. Chiffon, there are far too many parts of the map that I haven't mapped yet.
I love how the options for what installations I want to buy for my house are a bed, lighting, or a door.
Yep, you gotta pay for those.
Yeah, I know. just, you bought the house, yeah, but doesn't have a bed, doesn't have a lighting, doesn't have any furniture.
Why do you think no one fucking bought it before? It doesn't have shit in it.
It does remind me of the, it was a part of Earthbound I never even knew existed, the house thing that you were discussing on the podcast. I didn't know that existed until I listened to the podcast.
I didn't find it in-game at all.
I did. I didn't spend the money on it, though.
And buy it and there's a wall missing, which is great.
Okay. So apparently from here I am going up to the third floor straight away. There are so many of them. These can be fought.
I was gonna make a joke about how this is gonna be my Final Fantasy 15 experience, but then I realized that I'll probably end up playing it eventually, much to the detriment of my very being.
I mean, it's pretty short, unless you want to do everything, which isn't worth doing.
I mean, I'm kind of even hesitant with that. I'd say that you should definitely at least, like, explore the majority of the map and maybe do some side stuff, because to me, that was the best part of the game, is just...
Yeah.
Driving around the world map and stuff.
Yeah. The looking for stuff side quests are alright. Some of the optional dungeons are fucking awful.
Oh, yeah, yeah,
although,
yeah,
definitely do the volcano, because the volcano's good.
Volcano is very good. No, most of the optional dungeons you can ignore.
Fucking Kosselmark Tower. Which isn't a tower! I'm still mad about that.
Yeah. But yeah, the volcanoes... the volcanoes... It might be actually my favorite part of the game, actually. It's just a nice, like... get through this path and, you know, and eventually you get that nice view, and you get a tease for a boss fight, but I forget if it doesn't happen or if it's part of a side quest later.
It's a different side quest. And also, I think technically the boss fight doesn't happen there. I want to contact these. Because they're annoying.
Me actually playing Final Fantasy XV is like months off yet.
Yeah.
Yeah,
no PC port so far.
Yeah, I was about to say, they didn't even announce a PC port yet, which... I mean, I'd imagine it has to be coming, but also it's Square Enix, so...
It could be 2 years yet.
Yeah.
I mean, what I'm thinking is they might just wait until all the DLC is done, and then
that's
just...
That's true, actually.
Which... But also, my computer probably won't be able to run it, because...
Yeah, that's also an issue.
Hence also, the next 3 months being Patreon money going towards building my computer to not be crap so I can edit stuff and also play video games. Yay.
Reminds me, I just remind myself that I did buy the FF15 season pass like a goof.
Whoops.
I bought that when I was a couple hours into the game and I was like, yeah, I'm really enjoying this. You know, I'm kind of waiting for the story stuff to get good, but...
I mean, but, like, know, I was quite tight for money just when it came out, so... Like, I was spared the indulgences of buying, like, DLC and Season Pass. I did buy the guide. I'm very glad I bought the guide. Even though it's not a very pretty guide. Where am I going from save point? Moving south.
I did watch the Gladiolus DLC trailer, and it's like, oh, you get to fight I think it's Gilgamesh or something. I think that's who it is.
Yeah, I think so.
But like, I saw the design, and it's like some hooded guy, and I'm like, that's not Gilgamesh. In fact, they should just straight up put the. World of Final Fantasy version in there.
The World of Final Fantasy Gilgamesh is pretty good.
He's fantastic.
Right there.
Quick save, time to... Can I go... Nope, I can't teleport, but I can go to... Can go to the park.
I went west from the stairs, and there's bullshit that way too.
Final Fantasy XIV Gilgamesh is the best Grig.
I've only seen the cutscenes for that because he's part of the
Hildebrand.
Yeah, the Hildebrand, which I've seen all the cutscenes for those because I don't have the time or money to play Final Fantasy XIV, but I'll watch those Hildebrand cutscenes on YouTube.
Oh, these clowns are zombies now.
Oh, yeah.
I already fought you before these things before.
Oh, did you attack the amusement park people when you went there first?
No,
nope,
I was talking about the zombie clowns.
Oh, okay.
I didn't fight the tank first time I went there.
No, but I avoided all combat except for... I think it was weird that, like, the roller coaster bit has them attacking you. Like,
but
didn't
also
any...
the ones that attack you during the roller coaster aren't wearing the costumes.
Oh... I don't know. I just thought that was weird. It's like, no, I'm peaceful. Why are you suddenly attacking?
Yeah, they attack you even if you go on the roller coaster again. Like, they're just there to attack you.
I mean, I guess I can understand they just want to give you something to do, but I don't know, just watching a roller coaster go is enough for me to do anyway, but I don't know. Also, Onomata and Platinum in general are probably just more
build this thing with combat instead of just let that thing happen.
Yeah, because, you know, I need to be playing the video game at all times.
Mm-hmm. I mean, all the shooter sections, almost all the shooting is trivial. Like, all the way through the Sunken City shmup bit, there's just this rain of nothing enemies for no significant reason. Whoops.
I guess.
Maybe they make it a bit more difficult on normal and harder, I guess. What am I talking about? Ocelots.
Maybe that's what I'll do when I get back to it, is playing on hard. Because
don't play on very hard, because that sounds like some bullshit.
Oh, no. I would never play it on very hard, because that just sounds not fun. But maybe hard would be interesting.
It turns off the lock-on, but also I feel like the lock-on is one of the only reasons this game functions well. So,
I mean, yeah, it's a Zelda game. You can't have a Zelda game without lock-on.
I mean, the original Nier was a Zelda game and it didn't have a lock-on, but that's because the camera wasn't ass.
Also, like, original Nier, a lot less flashy in the combat department.
Yeah, the particle effects are like an actual fucking problem in this game.
Yeah. Like, I'm trying to imagine the game without lock-on, and the way I'd fight is, like, I'd have my hand pretty much glued to the frickin', fire button and just have that down at all times, because, hey, it's free chip damage.
Yeah, like, the fact that it's not, like, a toggle is what fucks me up consistently. Like,
well, another thing is that, in the original, and they probably caught it pretty easily.
Why
but,
am I suddenly getting so many fucking back attacks?
Headlock.
In the original Nier, the standard magic blast is actually the most OP attack in the game if you just spam the button, because the initial bullet in a volley does bonus damage, so if you just
three
spam the button,
damage, yeah.
they all have three times damage, and just everything's health bar just melts, and that's great.
Yeah, but like, I honestly, most of the time, I forget that I have to hold the button, and I'm not doing extra chip damage, and it just kind of sucks. Like, it's stupid that they made that an easy only thing. Like, just make your fucking gun fire whenever you're fighting shit would be like a normal ass thing to have.
The auto chips, I don't know why they locked them to difficulty, because if you didn't want them, you just don't equip them.
Yeah,
like, I don't get why they also need to be easy mode only. It doesn't make any sense. Like,
because that's what they did for fucking Bayonetta. Like, it's just Platinum being Platinum and being dumb about it.
I guess. I just don't remember it being as noticeable in Bayonetta.
That's so, because also, you have to specifically pick easy automatic.
I guess. I don't know. I need to get around to playing Bayonetta Wii U and 2, because I bought those and it's been forever since I played Bayonetta. But also, I hate playing my Wii U, because my in-room setup is just the worst, and I don't feel like fixing it.
Right, so I got to this floor.
Oh man, the shockwave goes through walls. I love it.
Shockwave's another chip that I didn't know existed until I watched Half Coordinated has an A-ending speedrun he made a video of recently. And I've been meaning to ask him, how much does chip RNG affect the run? Because, like, unless it's a store-bought one, they are entirely random.
Yeah, and, like, it probably does affect it to a degree, but also, like, there's just the fact that you can, if with enough patience, fuse your way up to good chips.
Yeah.
But
it's also just a huge money sink.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I'm talking like, about in a
word RNG yeah, does affect the original Nier speedrun pretty significantly. Just for quick kill strats.
I suppose. I didn't watch as many speedruns of the original Nier. I think I've watched there was a GDQ run. Maybe
SGDQ or what? SGDQ 2013 with OmniGamer.
Yeah.
Oh fuck, this is a lot of enemies. Oh, and I just taunted all of them.
Whoops.
Yes! No, I wanted that.
Oh, by the way, I found out, you know the gravity pod power?
Yeah.
There's enough time that you can set gravity going and it will collect everything in that it's going to collect in the time it takes you to switch to the hammer power up.
Yeah.
If you've got the hammer on your other pod, and that's a good combo.
I use bomb instead. Also, I fucking died.
I rarely used any of those except for like laser because.
Also, I'm playing as this extra character and I don't get to do a body run. It just makes me load. That's so nice. I don't have to fucking worry about chip shit.
Ugh.
Yeah. I don't have to worry about that if I die as her. Cool. That being said, I should sell some shit and then go fuse some shit and then re-sort my chips.
Doing on this floor? step out of the room and go northeast. That must be over. Oh my god, how did I miss this bit? I was right there! I was like 10 squares from here! Oh. Now I has a sad. Right. East. South. Whoops. Don't give me that face, Chiffon. There will be a reckoning.
Okay. I have a lot of weapon attack plus threes, so I'm gonna upgrade a couple into plus fours, and then combine those into plus fives, and then I have a plus five. So now I have a plus six. That's cool. I don't think it can get any higher, given that it's not listed anymore. Shockwave plus three. Okay, fire shockwave.
Yeah, I don't know. When I do get back to Onomata, I'm definitely gonna take a closer look at like chips I didn't use because there's a whole lot of them I just never touched because.
Yeah.
My build was. For like the first chunk of the game, it was bonus experience, which I eventually removed because it didn't seem that important. And then I definitely tried to get the drop rate one as high as possible, so I'd just be swimming in items.
Yeah.
I ship south to... oh, good grief.
And then I'd just have, like, range attack and regular attack up, and I think... And typically that'd be most of space taken up.
Taunt up times four.
Oh, another thing that really bugged me is when you're playing as I believe when you're playing as 2B or 9S and you taunt, the characters don't do a taunt.
Yeah, no, they don't.
Instead you just kind of flash your flashlight and the enemies get angry, and I didn't like that. A2 is the only one who does an actual taunt when you taunt.
Yeah.
Because, like, for a while I was like, am I just not hitting this stick correctly or something? And then I eventually noticed, like, oh, wait, no, they're getting mad. There's just no animation, and that's no fun.
Shame.
Half the fun of a taunt is the character just going, like, no, I'm gonna beat you or whatever.
I don't know that they can do taunts. I think you're just flashing the flashlight in their faces because there's a flashlight.
No, they get angry. The robots, their heads...
Yeah, I know, but, like, I don't think that they have a taunt move so much as you're just flashing a flashlight in their fucking faces.
Yeah, but I think it still gives the taunt effect.
No, it's A2 only. Like...
You sure?
Yeah.
Because I was mashing the stick with the 2B.
That literally just flashes the light. And if that does actually make them mad, kudos, I guess, but I never noticed that.
I'm pretty sure it does, because I got a bunch of robots and, like, their heads. And it's very noticeable because their heads, like light up and they're angry.
Well, I got some fucking robots out here. I can shine a light in their faces and see if that happens.
I am almost certain, because I got the taunt power up before I even unlocked A2, and I was like,
yeah, no, I did too.
I'm like, oh, well, I'm not doing the taunt, so maybe I need to have the chip equipped, and then, you know, I equipped the chip, and that didn't, and I don't think that did anything, but I do remember getting robots mad at me by flashing the flashlight at them.
I mean, they might have a lower level, like, aggro effect beyond taunt.
Yeah, no, it got him mad, but also, fuck that, actually? Like, why would you let that happen?
Because you do bonus damage to them, but they can
no,
also
No, I mean,
bonus
fuck
damage.
That, why would you put that on that button? Why would you let you flashlight this?
Oh, yeah, that's what I'm talking about, there's no animation for it.
No, I mean, why let that functionality happen? Why do that, Platinum? Do the animation...
Oh,
yeah.
You mean the flashlight? Like,
why make the flashlight make them angry, for one, and why put it on that fucking button if you're gonna do that, for two? Fuck
well,
that.
Because it is kind of an out of the
way input. I found a plot room.
I'm just mad at the concept of, yeah, here's a flashlight that you can flash in their faces, and it makes them mad, and we put it on the worst fucking button possible. Fuck Platinum!
I'm trying to think if that's a standard thing for them, or maybe it's right stick, I don't remember.
I know that fucking Bayonetta 1, at least, has it just on the left bumper.
Oh, does it?
Yeah, like, it's just a fucking button. And... yeah, fucking in Metal Gear Rising, Jetstream Sam can taunt, and it's on his VR, like the button that Raiden uses for AR mode, which is just a fucking button.
Okay. So that is something specific to Automata.
Ooh, we got a cutscene.
I guess it's because Automata has so many freaking.
Holy crap!
Yeah.
That's definitely nuking the original universe, or making a giant temple there.
Okay, time to sort my fucking plug-in chips.
I don't know. But I do agree, that's a bad place for your taunt button. And also, a incredibly unclear taunt.
It's not even like an actual taunt, because A2 has like an actual taunt. It's just this little Easter egg that you can do that is stupid. I'm mad.
I just don't get why they didn't give everybody a taunt. Because even turning the flashlight on and off, that's not a functionality that gets used. Because yeah. I think if you go into a dark place, the flashlight just turns on automatically.
No, it doesn't.
Oh, it doesn't?
Nope. Well, then
it should do that. Because yep, what's the point?
It should.
What's the point on standing around in the dark and having a flashlight lit? I guess because they didn't want to make everybody a taunt animation. Which is weird, because that sounds like a thing that Platinum would prioritize, because they're Platinum.
Yeah.
Though, I don't know. I guess Raiden didn't have a taunt, though. And maybe they wanted to make that feel unique to A2.
But 9S also. Yeah, I don't know.
Does 9S have a taunt?
No, he doesn't.
Okay. Well, yeah, that's what I mean. Maybe they wanted the taunt animation to feel like a unique thing to A2.
And... yeah, but also, then why give the flashlight the ability to do that? It's dumb.
I liked it better as builds, Chiffon. Those builds! You totaled those builds!
The worst part is that if you do just buy a bunch of shit and use them together, the cost for them goes up ridiculously. So you just want to get drops, which sucks.
Yeah, I realized that pretty quickly. It's like, oh, I can just buy anything, any chip I want and upgrade it all the way. And it's like, oh wait, no, their cost is ridiculous, and I've really no way to reduce those, so, whoops.
Yeah. I guess I'll live with this Shockwave Plus 2 until I get a more natural Shockwave Plus 4. Because I want it, but 23 points is a lot. I will get Charge Attack Plus 3 since I have a character who can Charge Attack now. And also the Mega Taunts. To make space for... I need to strip 7 out of here, so... Actually, I probably don't need Charge Attack.
Oh, that's an unfortunate mute.
I had the space on the stupid chip for weapon attack up plus 6, 50% weapon based attack boost. Now it gives me the fucking manual. Mash the fucking... This is bullshit. Oh my god, I'm so mad that it only gave me the... Mash the fucking flashlight button to taunt. Oh my god. I am actually mad that it only now gave me that tutorial. No, they're not still random drops. They're just... They're usually better than just fucking telling you in playthrough fucking C that you can taunt with a character who can taunt anyways. Fuck me. So dumb.
I'm glad I abandoned Horse and Kakariko so I can tell where on Earth it is on my map. Because trying to remember where all the towns are is a bit much.
God, the 300%, 50% damage on the taunted enemies is pretty fucking good. I just shredded through a pair of fucking horse monsters. Horse robots.
Also, I wish they labeled the goddess statues on your map.
Yeah, you pretty much just have to remember that most of the villages have them somewhere.
Well, even within the village, like, it took me forever to even find, the one in, well, in most of them, actually, like,
Yeah.
Which is like, okay, I have all these, points I want to invest, but I can't find the frickin' statues because I don't remember where they are.
Oh, come on! This fucking Goliath stomped on me and I couldn't even, like, do a platinum QTE to raise its stupid foot off me.
Nope.
It's bullshit.
The weird thing about Automata is that it's very platinum until, like, you get to certain bits where it's like, well, of course there has to be the platinum bit here, and then there's not.
Yeah.
Like, it's kind of inconsistent with how much of a Yoko Taro game it feels like, and how much of a platinum game it feels like. It seems a bit of an uneasy mix.
It's probably always going to be that, to be fair.
Yeah, I mean... like, I'm trying to think of some early examples. Actually, QTEs in general, there's barely any of them, from what I remember.
Yeah.
There aren't even that many big finisher type things.
Yeah.
Which would have been appropriate given how near manhandled everything.
Yeah,
that's one of the things I kind of feel like, was kind of a missed potential, because it's like, okay, if Platinum's making a near sequel, at least let me play the big Dark Hand cutscenes, but make it control like Wonder Red or something like that.
Yeah, the only thing that is maybe comparable is when, is it at the very beginning actually, when Nines hacks the arm off of the giant Goliath, and then you punch him with it.
Yeah, that.
But apparently that was also the demo.
Yeah. The demo and the intro to the game, which I'm kind of shocked is the intro, because it's the most platinum that game gets, like, ever, which is kind of odd.
Like, yeah,
there's bits and pieces, I mean, other than obviously the combat polish, but mostly, like, cool big set piece cutscenes, and there's not a lot of those.
Yeah, I felt like people were like, oh, this is a really platinum game when the demo came out, and I was kind of worried that it would be too platinum, but it really isn't all that platinum. And the bits that are kind of too platinum for me are few and far between.
They don't even really do a proper like rival style fight with A2. Like,
yeah,
the A2 fight is kind of weird.
Oh, I just realized I have a whip. I can get up there. A wire.
Which, like, oh, yeah,
wow,
the...
there's, like, no fucking cooldown on this whip. Or wire.
Hmm. Yeah, I remember that one being weird. Like...
ah, oh, motherfuck. Finally, I can get up here and get this fucking treasure chest. Memory alloy. That means I can upgrade another weapon to 4.
eyes, all the bad encounters as well.
Yeah, stay out there, asshole.
Alright.
Yeah, I got taunt killed. Nice. I got murdered hard because 50% goes both ways. Yeah, this is just reminding me that I need to play like every other platinum game.
I don't know. The weird thing about platinum games is that like I just haven't gotten around to, like, at least finishing a lot of them. Like, I really like Wonderful 101. I haven't played too much into it, though.
Yeah.
Because playing on my Wii U is... It's not even really a hassle. I'm just lazy. Like, I don't want to move around stuff in my room, or I don't want to move my Wii U down to the living room. Like... And most of the platinum stuff I have right now is all on Wii, is Bayo 1 and 2 and Wonderful 101.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't mind playing it on Wii U. Like, I played the entirety of my 50 hours of Breath of the Wild on Wii U.
I don't hate the Wii U or anything. I like it as a console. It's just I have it set up in my room now, and I don't really have my entertainment stand set up in my room at all. It's like,
yeah,
I don't know, I have my monitor thrown up somewhere and I have everything hooked up to it, but there's like, I don't know, there's just so much crap in my room that I need to sort through that I just never have.
Oh god, why?
It sounds like Becky's playing Persona 1.
You are not wrong.
Because that would be my reaction of most of that game, is, oh no, god, why?
I need to go to bed in like 20 minutes. I did want to do a long stream this evening, but I was hoping to do more than one dungeon in that time. God damn. I mean, like, I've gained a lot of levels and a bunch of cards and stuff, so it's not been wasted time at all. But, oh god. Here's a reason for not fully exploring every dungeon like Chiffon wanted me to. It means that my where I've already been marks a path out of the place.
Yeah, that's typically useful for games that just don't give you an easy exit out of the dungeon or
yeah. Yoma. Can I see Yoma? Oh shit.
I really hate the Goliaths with the electric legs.
Yeah.
They are a bit of a pain. Oh, that's right, those are the ones that I actually can't recruit because I don't have the right party member.
God, I just remember the weird party member stuff in that game.
Fortunately, they're weak to fire, and I do have a character with Maragi.
Most of my memory of Persona 1 is, boy, I remember that game being bad, and then remembering something that I totally forgot. Wow, that game's worse than I remember.
Sounds about right. But I have made it out of the dungeon. I hate that whoever wrote this game legitimately thinks that Nanjo is smart. It's like, what? No. This is a really annoying encounter. What are these noises?
Ha
Right. That will do it for today. Thanks for keeping me company. Alrighty. I definitely needed it.